horse to reach into the bridle under saddle.
Right.
Right? Because a lot of times we ride, like I have a picture where there's Maverick being ridden, and I had Lori holding back, like crunching back.
Yeah, I saw that.
Yep. And you could see that A, his face was very unhappy, but two, so the horse's saliva inventory glands, I think they're called parotid glands, are right back here behind the cheekbone. And you'll see it in your side horses a lot, but any horse that's ridden back like this all the time, you'll see big, huge bunches there. And that's the parotid or inflammatory gland with a lot of inflammation.
Oh.
And they can cause, you can actually cause issues. And also, if you ride them behind the vertical a ton, you can injure the hyoid too. So we don't want to ride, we want the horse to want to reach forward and down rather than pull them back. You know, a lot of times what we do is we try to pull them back into the position rather than teaching them the horse to move forward down into the position.
Yes.
Okay? So we want to stand like we're riding. You know, we're going to stand here because initially we're going to ride. And in the beginning, what I do is once my horse understands the idea, the concept from the halter, I'll reach over. And then I will pick up, make light contact. And in this case, because he knows how to do this, I'm just going to wait until he drops his nose. So I'll show you how to do this once that does it. Well, let's say he didn't. So let's say he does it. So I'll do this, and then head down.
Okay.
And then let him hang out there. And then he'll probably pop his head up here in a minute. And I'll just repeat that. Okay. And then, oh, here we go. Head comes up. Pick up. Okay, there we go. Pick up. But you see how he wants to just do vertical flexion?
Yeah, that's what he does.
Don't want that. I want him to do this and go down here.
Yeah.
And take that. And I can, you know, I can use my rein to like straighten his head up and stuff. There. There's a little better. Don't want that. Hold.
This position.
And you can use both hands, Carol, initially. So like rein, hand on rein.
So put it back.
And hold. If nothing happens, then I'll reach down and pull the head down.
Mm-hmm.
Like, whoa, there you go.
He's like that.
Same thing, I'll hold. And you may not get this in one session, like it may take multiple sessions.
Yep, it would, because he's the vertical. I mean, when you.
Yep. But you don't want him to back up.
Right.
That's the difference. Like,
right.
If your horse starts backing up, then we need to walk forward.
Right. I thought he would back up. I was surprised.
That hold. Now, if he doesn't get it, then I'll use one hand to hold and then pull down.
Is he ridden in a snowball?
Yeah, that's his.
You want your he's so soft that when I do take hold, he's like trying to get behind it. Don't want that. And I might even, if I need to, I might do a little left, right, left, right.
Yeah, I was thinking of that with him.
Not really like, I don't want to do this. It's just kind of tipping their head to the left and tipping their head to the right to bring their head down or bring them back into position.
When I ride him with his, you know, that high port, higher port bit, it's like I don't really hold pressure. It's just almost like you don't even see my hand, but it's just a little movement, and so that's why I'm not sure if he's gonna be dumb in the snap of it. That's what I'm saying.
See how you can hold him back up.
Right. I can see him wanting to do that vertical flex.
Him, yeah.
But even Julia's doing that. And
I'm
show off.
Like,
but I mean, she's doing that flexion too. She's flexing too much.
I see.
Yeah, there you go. Good. I've done it that way too. Now, once the horse can. Can you stand me on your side? Yeah, it doesn't matter. Just age your side of it. Yeah, no flags. Perfect. Thank you.
This is something I need to do a lot with him. I need to do this a lot with him. Like, how often, what should I do it with him, I guess?
I'd be like,
I don't get riding right now. I know. I got him back for a while.
I
think
I just come in and start doing this stuff. You have to ride it.
I know. That's what I'm thinking.
You can just come in here and.
Because even after she can start riding again, I still want to continue.
Yeah.
Me doing it though.
Because what you can do is once. So once your horse can do this at a standstill, then what I'll do is start doing it at a walk. Never mind your side, what can come in handy. And this is where your horse initially is going to be like, what the frick? Like, you don't walk here. So what I might do is I start walking, and I want the horse to walk, and I want to be back by the shoulders.
Okay.
Okay, and I'll do this with my young horses to start teaching steering and stopping without having the long line. Doesn't mean you can't long line, just. And you can teach them to soften and everything before you ever get off. So at first I get them comfortable with them walking forward. Back here. Okay. A lot of horses feel really weird with you walking back here with your hand on their neck. This is an odd position for most humans. And you can pull their rein forward if you need to or have it through it. Then, once my horse is walking forward, then I'm going to go up and make contact with my rein. Just like I was. But while they're walking forward, and hold until they soften a little bit or reach down. And he's just softening a little bit.
Right.
But that's where he's at. So that's where I'm going to take it.
figured out.
Right.
I'm going to add contact. Wait for him to either soften or release. Got to walk forward. There, a little softening. And see, I can steer, teach my horse to steer, pull my right rein or my left rein. Like your ground drive, I'll go from the side.
Right, exactly. Constant pressure then.
Nope.
Oh, that's
not
nice.
No, only like I'll maintain contact.
Right, but
now every time that horse softens, then I'll release.
Right, okay.
But I'll hold contact until he.
Yeah. That's what I was saying earlier. Yeah.
He is so, and if he really struggles, you may want to put him in a rope halter and do what Lori's doing. Because you're like, he may just need that extra step in between.
Yeah.
If he doesn't get this. But that's why I like doing this with young horses, like to teach them to soften and in the bridle and steer
right.
And all that stuff, because I can stay with them, and I feel like compared to long lines, my timing is so much easier. Because not in the long lines, it's like, okay, turn, and then there's this huge delayed reaction and all this stuff. But with this, you know, I can get there a lot quicker or stop them a lot sooner, whatever the case may be. And it also kind of gets them used to you being a little further back if you're getting ready to ride. You know, you're going to be back here. And I just find that it's a lot easier. Because then eventually, like, maybe they get good at that. And then I can be from this position and start asking for lateral motion, you know, from here.
Yeah, I think I'll bring his, I just took his rope halter home. Let me bring it back.
But that's how we started. And then obviously once they're good walking with you on the ground like that, then you get in the saddle and you pick up the reins, you make contact, and the horse already knows
right.
What to do. And then you just do it under saddle.
So he's been trained that way, but over probably the last few years I've noticed, you know, before any thing I'm going to ask of him, I just raise my hand up, you know, and he lifts his head some, but he almost does the vertical, you know.
Yeah,
because
the reiners always tuck them back
yeah,
behind, you never notice that. The reiners always get them to their chest and really get them
yeah.
Soft and
but there's some
over.
Reiners, though, they are more low and
stretched out, yeah.
Yeah, and I like that it looks more natural.
Yeah, I think it just depends on the trainer, obviously,
yeah.
But you know, it's going to be harder for you to retrain him than like Lori's training it
right.
Brand new.
Right.
So she's training into it now versus you have to on train, like this guy, he's kind of training, he's a little too behind.
Mm-hmm.
He's too soft. He needs to reach forward down. So like if I was riding him, I would spend a lot of time like not trying to reward this, but reward this.
Yes, yes.
More.
Yeah.
Because he's soft. Yes, he's soft. Great, but he needs to be a little more brave to reach through.
Yeah.
Our horse should never be afraid to make contact with our hands.
Right. So.
Yes. thoroughbred. Sometimes I quit a little early on this and get on because my arms get too tired with the tall ones.
Ginger would be just...
Perfect, right?
She's really got good though.
Do you want to try this part though?
Sure.
I've got a horse coming in for training. I have to go tell them where they need to put it.
I don't even know what time this is.
It's 4:45.
Oh,
so we're about ready to be done anyways.
Oh. Here,
can
hold the
light if
you want.
Maybe
try walking.
Okay.
Maybe try flexing.
I'll show her where to put it and then they can get it in that area and then we'll find it.
Bring a new one in?
Yep. So you're just going to have your hand on each side like you're riding. And then you're going to pick up your make contact.
I know he's a, you know, he's a train, but I still think I can get him to go a little longer with his head.
Yeah.
Rather than get so far behind that vertical flexion.
Yeah.
Or are you guys gonna ride?
Oh.
really bear down. I'm like, and then I ask Mike or Miley or Bruce, and then, you know, I think, oh, I'm like a half hour ordeal on this. I'm like, you lost me in the first 3 minutes.
He's like running around. It was hilarious.
Who was squealing?
Julia.
Oh.
We let him in here to run around, and she'd just take off and be like,
yeah.
Funny. She's so funny. She's so funny.
Could you just, I'm going to shut that off. Yeah. Could you just put bridle, just the motions of how you taught her to put her bridle on?
Yeah.